So today we're going to look at sensitivity analysis in Microsoft Excel. This is Microsoft Excel 2016 in a business scenario where we want to look at different combinations. So sensitivity analysis is basically a type of analysis where you look at different combinations of assumptions and you examine the result. So here we're going to look at a different number of units sold and different price points to look at the profit at these different combinations. So I set up a very simple financial model. We have assumptions. Let's assume this is a chair store. We are selling 1,000 chairs a year, $150 a chair, and our cost per chair is $50. And our fixed costs, which are our store rent and our payroll, are right here. And so if you look at our income statement or profit and loss, we have our revenue, our cost of sales, we have our gross profit, fixed costs, and our operating profit. So I want to analyze our operating profit and look at different number of units sold. So what I'm thinking about is, okay, so I want to change the price. So I'm going to change the price, but I know if I raise the price, I'll probably sell fewer chairs. And if I lower the price, I'll probably sell more chairs. So what really is the best combination for my operating profit? And so let's, you know, to answer this question very quickly, we're going to need to build a sensitivity analysis table. So here's how you construct a table. The first piece of this is basic formatting. So I like to put a line along each edge of the table so it's very clear sort of what we're doing. We start here. And along the row axes, I want to do chairs sold. So here's where we're going to look at different numbers of units. And along the column, we're going to do price of the chair. So chairs sold. In the midpoint, let's do 1,000. And on the midpoint here, let's do 150, because that's what our current model has for the assumptions. But I want to look at sort of the tail end up and down. So let's look at 750, 500, 1250, and then 1500. So we know at a higher price point, we'll probably sell fewer chairs. So maybe this is 175, and maybe this is 200. And you know, as we have lower price points, you'll see that we'll sell probably more chairs. So now that we've set up the basic table, there's one last step, and you need to link in the result that you want the table to populate, which is operating profit. So you link it in here in the corner of the table. So at this point, you highlight the entire table, including that corner. You go to the data tab, and then what if analysis. Select data table, and for your row input, we have chairs sold, and you need to link in the actual assumption. So we've linked in our row input, and then column input, we have price. So we'll link in price, and if we click OK, we will populate the table with operating profit. So at $100 and 1,500 chairs, we'll actually make $15,000 of operating profit, which is less than our current model. And so what we see here is some of these higher price points, you know, at 500 chairs and $200, we're making only $15,000 compared to the current model here. So these types of tables will allow us to price products and just look at the results as things change. And they're very helpful in business. So I actually have a course focused on Excel for business analysts, and I have it on Udemy. I'll include a link to that in the details. Thank you for listening.